Century, yes, wildlife sanctuary, where salt producers and wildlife live together since hundreds of years. How do I am going to mitigate all that? First, government are already a partner, since we have signed an MOU with them. We are going to brand salt jointly with government as well as some private players. Big Bazaar has shown interest in this, doing this. Diversify procurement channels, including marine salts. Expand product portfolio by byproducts. Build strong management team with domain expertise. I'll be doing it, all right. The key figures are, we are going to jump from 40 salt producers to 2,500 salt producers in coming 5 years' time. And for that, our revenues will grow from half a crore to 168 crore in coming 5 years. We will need capital in two forms, equity and debt, and we have estimated it as totally 7.4 crore or 7 crore, of which 3.5 crore is what we expect as equity, the rest as a debt. Why do we need all this money? We are going to set up a processing plant of our own. We need first 100 pumps to be funded so that we can create interest of the credit institutions to provide us institutional credit to expand our work. And secondly, we need money for our working capital operations. What kind of impact we will create? We will create economic impact in terms of 5,000 livelihoods in coming 5 years. We'll increase their income by 240% and profitability by 240%. They will get assets in form of solar pumps because we are going to give them away after 5 years, 5 to 7 years, once they pay up the rent and the cost for it. Mind you, I have not put any subsidies into this consideration in my calculation. If I get subsidies, I can do it in 5 years or less than 5 years. The most important thing is they will get free from the clutches of the trader and they will be able to freely sell this salt in open market. Today they cannot. And connecting producers to the market through a brand. Social impact will be the most important in my opinion, restoring their status from a laborer to an owner. And secondly, they will get an institutional identity in form of Sabras as an enterprise with a professional governance. Environmentally, everybody knows we will be replacing diesel and using a more renewable energy. What kind of investment partner we are looking at? Somebody who has a mission and approach alignment, willingness to forge long-term partnerships, collaborative approach to address challenges and facilitate network beyond profits and funds. I request you to invest in Sabras for the second salt march towards prosperity of all. Thank you for your time. Did I do it all right?
I have one question on the number of fronts that you are working on. And in particular, the notion of building the brand on the market. How much this is kind of a byproduct because as you're helping the production process and the value chain, you also have the opportunity to do this extra effort. Or how much is this a primary objective? Because again, once again, the question is one of how many things you can do at the same time.
Well, this is not at the same time. This is going to be over a period of 5 years. Secondly, I have a very strong partner in government as well as with the private player. And I think I am going to control 30% of the producers. I can tell whose salt I'm selling. No other brand can do that. That's the uniqueness. On my bag, I can print, this is the fellow whose salt I'm selling. And therefore, I'm uniquely positioned. Secondly, if I control 30 to 40% of the production market, I think I can influence other people's rates also. So that's the catch. So that's what I'm trying to sort of do.
I wanted to ask you the question, when you identified the lack of institutional credit as being one of the main reasons why their margins are, fractional, I don't even know what to call it. Why did you choose the approach of actually going for the solar pump and, you know, through that method rather than actually figuring out how to get them institutional credit or provide them institutional credit?
No, I think what I did in 3 years, I realized I can go and raise the procurement price up to a point because I have to compete with other players. And I didn't want to make a lot of enemies to start with. So I realized that let me look at the cost structure. 60% of the cost of the salt production for small salt producer in desert is diesel. And it is for this that they borrow money from the money lenders.
Right.
And therefore, they lock the price at the beginning of the season. And I thought if I can cut that cord, I'm doing three things. I'm increasing the profitability of the salt producer by reducing cost. Secondly, I'm freeing him from the clutches of the trader. And third, I'm impacting environment by reducing use of diesel or replacing the use of diesel. So it is not just to avoid the institutional credit.
Sure.
And secondly, I think we need to have an asset creation for the salt producer. And I think that will give them much better. Secondly, this salt is produced for 8 months in a year. The remaining 4 months, they can use the same solar pump for their home, for energy. So I thought it's a fantastic crack at the problem.
Rajesh, I would like you to comment on my statement. I think 3.5 crores is pretty low for creating a brand.
No, I am not using this 3.5 crore for brand building. I'm only using it for first 100 pumps, setting up a processing plant, and for rest of the things, I'm going to do that as we grow. And we have already tied up with government saying Sabras will come up. There is a Mission Mangalam government is saying. So the brand in Gujarat would be Sabras Mangalam. And with Future Group, we are exploring possibility of Fresh and Pure in Sabras. But eventually, I want to drop both of them. And I'm going to invest from my own revenues eventually. So it's a long haul. And I know, you know, creating a brand is going to be tough.
Do you see this next round of capital coming in as actual investment in equity? And if so, how do you feel about the likelihood that that presumably reduces your position in the original founders quite a bit?
No, I don't think I'm going to sell out to, I'm not going to allow all the money to come as equity. I would like to start with debt. And the way I'm looking at is that there will be four partners in the equity. We have already decided to set up a producers organization which will take about 25% equity. Government, I am trying to pursue to take 10%. SAVE will put 45%. And I am requesting a private investor to come with 20-25% of the raised money. I think the strength of Sabras is the collaborative investments that it has made. And what I think we need here are two resource, type of resource. One is that we need to scale up the solar pump business because that's where it's going to change the structure. And that I'm ready to take debt. And then attract other people to come in for debt. The second area where I think we need to do some investments are in the people and the capacity. Because I think the biggest challenge in social enterprises is this changing of mindsets, including of the producers. And that is not subsidies, it is not charity. We are looking at hardcore wealth generation processes. And for that, you need to talk about investments and not donations. So that investment and bringing them into this corporate structure is where I think we need to invest something on that, that change of mindsets into these things. So capacity building part of it. So it will be the proposed equity structure that we are looking at is this. Thank you.
For 4 years, we have set up 3 plants and tried to perfect the model which we have been we have set up. And we intend to go up to 100 plants in 3 years and scale up further beyond that, but we really haven't projected beyond the third year. The social impact which we are bringing about is not only in terms of providing electricity to a energy scarce region of India. It's also the change which we are bringing about in the ecosystem, that is in the agriculture, in the reclamation of wastelands, and providing livelihoods to people. What is very evident in from the work which we do is the income which is being generated for the people, for the rural farmers, in every aspect of the work which we are doing. The kind of investor we are looking at is somebody who, as it was pointed out in the morning, who a patient investor who has can give us the time to grow from 3 plants to 100 plants over 3 years, and maybe longer and more number of plants, and who has a social who invests in the social side of the business as well, because most of the work which we do does not give much of returns to the company, but it's giving huge returns to the people. A little bit of what we are. We're based in Bihar, but we intend to go into neighboring states of UP and Jharkhand. We won the Ashen Award in 2009 and recently the World Bank Development Marketplace Award. We have been operating 3 plants and have about 75 acres of wastelands developed. The customers whom we cater to are households for electricity, irrigation of that's the farmers, and micro industries. These are typical rural micro industries like grinding units or something of that sort, which run on diesel gensets, and now we are moving over to electricity. The raw material which we use is grown in the wastelands, which we reclaim, and we're not competing with agri residue, which is as it is scarce in rural areas. Now, to understand a business better, to understand one unit of our company. That is one plant which we set up, a small 32 kilowatt plant. The capital investment is around 28 lakh rupees, with a life of 8 to 10 years. One plant typically serves around 3 to 4 villages, connects directly to households and micro enterprises, with a monthly fixed charge of 75 rupees per connection. On a standalone basis, each plant is making a return on capital of about 20% and a payback of 4 years. We need a minimum of 1500 connections to make money, and to break even, we need only around 1000 connections. That's about 35% of utilization of capacity. We have not factored in our calculation additional income from micro industries, telecom towers, and carbon credits, which is a little difficult to obtain. We operate for around 29 to 30 days a month, and for 6 hours a day only. That's during the evening when the lighting is required. The customers, this kind of social impact which we are having, is currently the consumers are using diesel generators or kerosene lamps. It's reducing the cost of energy by the process which we do. Micro enterprises, again, they are benefiting by a reduced cost of energy, and in the process they're becoming viable, because with the increasing cost of energy from diesel gensets, they're becoming unviable and more units are shutting down. And with the entire